This video is sponsored by Magic Spoon. Magic Spoon lets you enjoy all of the fun flavors of your favorite cereals without all the tragic downfalls of regular cereal. I love cereal. I always have. But growing up, my mom, it was never on the shopping list because she didn't want us eating bowls of sugar. I always cherished sleeping over at friends' houses because I got to raid the pantry for the cereal collection. But these days, I avoid eating it because the gluten makes me bloat and all of the sugar tends to make me crash. So I was really excited to give Magic Spoon a try. Favorites were fruity and combining cocoa and peanut butter into the same bowl so it tastes like Reese's peanut butter cups. That was actually my mom's idea. Her and my sister were really excited to try it out, so they came over for a whole like taste test party. And yeah, that was my mom's ingenious concoction. Magic Spoon is so confident in their cereals that they are backed with a 100% questions asked. I would highly recommend giving it a try. I was very pleasantly surprised by how much I enjoyed every single flavor. So if you'd like to try it out for yourself, you can click the link in my description and use my code for $5 off. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much to Magic Spoon. Let's get on with the video.
I hope the things that I've brought is a brush because I wanted to try out some mic brushing. It's not something that I ever really normally do because I'm scared of doing it wrong. But a lot of people seem to really like it. So we're gonna this was over the course of, you know, the first 20 years of my life. But yeah, this is gonna be the first time a dog is completely my own. I'm completely responsible for it. this pup. I've been having nightmares about it. But I think it'll be okay. I think it'll be okay. I've just gotta keep researching. And stay committed and patient to training. And not getting discouraged. Sure what this puppy's temperament is gonna be like, but if he does tend to be more on the calmer side, it might be fun to do a grooming video. I'll wait till he's real sleepy. Bring out the brushes. He's a Cavalier Poodle mix, and so I read that it's really important to keep their coats extremely considering. For each one, I've got the full name and then the corresponding nickname. So, Edmund, but I'd call him Eddie. August, but I'd call him Gus, or Gus. And then I guess I must not be that crazy about the third one, because I can't even remember it. I've got my phone over here. You can look it up. I feel like I, you know, need to meet him, get a sense of his personality before I know which will fit the best, but so far I'm leaning towards Eddie. So... oh, okay, so Edgar for Eddie, August for Gus, and Wallace or Wally. Eddie, Gus, or Wally. And I'll show you a picture of him so you guys can tell me what name you think fits the best. There's the little boy. Eddie, right? Only time will tell. I went to Barnes & Noble and picked up the sequel to Six of Crows. Called Crooked Kingdom by Leigh Bardugo. Crooked Kingdom. If anybody's read it, please let me know how you liked it, how it compared to Six of Crows. But wow. I was at Barnes & Noble. Something caught my eye that I simply could not refuse. And that was this young lad. He's just like a really good shape. I think they designed him incredibly well. He is specifically designed to incite my maternal instinct. This bluish gray velvety elephant that is squishy in such a firm way. It's really nice. Reminds me of memory foam, I guess. Littlest snout. Eyes and big ears. His ears are sort of crinkly. And when I brought him up to the register, this elderly man, and he asked me, "Would you like the boy in a bag?" I said, "Yes, please. I would love the boy in a bag. He'll be very comfortable in there. He likes to
his ears massaged. I've had him placed on top of the top shelf of my bookshelf in the living room, keeping watchful eye over all the goings-ons. Sleepy, crinkly, resting. Pillows have got scraping at the edge. 1, 2, and 3 strips. Intermission is done. Let's pick out another prop. What about this? Is a whiteboard and reversible sequin panel combo. It's magnetic on the back because it's supposed to go in your locker. Some stripes. 1, 2, 3.
They smell amazing. A bit plasticky, but they definitely imbued them with a delectable fragrance of some sort. So I gotta squish them. They pop back up pretty quick. So good. Smells like an oat milk latte with chamomile. Chamomile oat milk latte. He's so around.
pocket. It was in my
autumn decor. I can't believe how soft it is.
The pink pumpkins.
And I didn't notice before how many different cats are on it. They're all black cats, but they've all got their own unique expressions and poses and things.
Like, this one looks real sneaky. See the snake? He's got the narrowed eyes. He's up to no good. And then this guy, he just looks sort of scared and confused. He's nervous, but he's not up to no good. Who else have we got in here? I like this guy. He's got his tail up. He looks kind.
There's a mic brushing with it. Let's try it. Oops, going very gently. This one's a bit. Your left ear. Then switch it over to your right ear.
The last thing I have for you tonight.
It's a bit of reading. This is Shel Silverstein, Ronnie Babbitt.
I'm shopping for a new couch, and for the life of me, I couldn't decide between a dark forest green or a light peachy pink. I've got lots of plants, and both of those colors I think would pair well with the plants. I ended up settling on dark green because I like to get so many antiques that I could just imagine the pink, the peachy pink. You know, what's been troubling me is that it feels like 90% of couches on the market right now, at least dark green couches, are made of velvet. And I don't want a velvet couch. I keep finding one that's perfect in every way, and I love it. But it's velvet. My curtains are velvet, and I don't want to have double truffle velvet living room, you know?
Okay, let's pick a Ronnie Babbitt bit.
Ronnie's new hobby. Ronnie's Hugh Nobby, I mean.
Ronnie Babbitt learned to lit and made a sweat and heater, and now he sadly will admit he might have done it meter.
His nickpick. One day, Ronnie Babbitt met little Franny Fogg. He said, "Let's have a nickpick."